Well, hello and welcome to Cimber Bushcraft. Yeah, I'm in my camp today, the first time in the new year, and happy new year to all of you, my wonderful subscribers. And as you saw, I have got a new flag, a new Raven flag. One of my wonderful subscriber is called John, and I think he's from Alaska. At least his email name is Alaska Man. But I'm very grateful for that, John. And you can see it's very nice out here in my camp, and I appreciate your kindness and support and generosity very much. And the reason why I got that new flag is because I had the old one stolen. As you probably know, I had a burglar here in December, I think it was, and he stole a lot of things, or they took a lot of things. So now I got my new flag up and officially opened the Cimber Camp. So I'm very grateful. Yeah, and today I'm out here. You can see I have my stove with me. And, it's very nice to have a heat out here when it's cold outside. It's about the freezing point, 0 degrees Celsius. And they actually talk about there'll be a little snow here. We had a little snow last, I think it was the weekend, last weekend. And well, most of it are gone again, and it had been quite warm for this time of year. But now I hope a little winter will come. So I really enjoy snow, and being out here in Cimber Camp in a snowstorm, snow blizzard, that would be cool. And I've talked with my good old friend Johnny. We're going to make an overnight out here during the winter, and if there was a little bit snow out here, that would be great too. So. And beside that, I have a little lunch I'm going to prepare, and of course, my coffee. Yeah. My latest video, the Warrior, I got a lot of very nice response for that, and I'm very grateful for that. But in my Viking series, the Trilogy, I don't drink coffee and I don't smoke my pipe, so now it's time again to do that, and I hope you enjoy that. Well, it's been a quiet Christmas and New Year. We usually is together with some friends New Year's Eve, but this year we decided to stay home because of the coronavirus. Our country, Denmark, is under lockdown now. We are still allowed to go out, but all children are home from school, and all the public service businesses are closed. You can still go into supermarkets and buy foods, but most of the other shops are closed. And this will be until the 17th of January, and perhaps longer. It's the new virus from England that is very, it's very contagious, more than the old one. So the government are fearing that our health system will collapse if too many people are sick and have to go to the hospital. Yeah, it's dangerous time we're living in. The new vaccines that are coming. Denmark is in full speed in vaccinating old people first, and then later to summer. I think I'll be the one, the last. But yeah, it's almost 1:30, and I'm actually hungry, so I think I'll make my little sandwich. I hope you like. Yeah, and first of all, let's see here. I got some red pepper. Yeah. And some onion. A little bit more there. And then I got some salami, which I like, and some cheese, brie or camembert. This is a nice combination, I think, and in all, this is going to be in this little bun that I'm going to warm over the stove now. It's very hot, so I don't think it's going to take very long before these breads are fried. You can see, very hot stove. Yeah. Just have to warm them up a bit, and then I think they will be delicious. Yeah. Oops, yeah. This is enough. And I know this is not healthy, but I do love mayonnaise on my sandwich. Not much, a little bit. And then the onions. Yeah. And the salami. And my knife is here. Yep. Some of this cheese. Oh yeah. So delicious. And then my salt and pepper. Just a little bit of pepper. Yep. And then some salt. Ooh, that was a lot. Then the red bell pepper on. A little bit more mayonnaise on this one, perhaps. Yeah. This is nice. Oh yeah. Well, I'm hungry, and this is one of my favorite sandwiches when I'm making them myself. Mm. You mustn't talk with food in your mouth, though. Maybe you noticed that my sound is getting better. It's actually because I've bought a new camera, a camera that can have a external microphone on, a better microphone in the one that is in the camera. This camera is a Canon M6 Mark II, and I tried it several times. The video from the Viking warrior was actually recorded with that camera, and this is the first official Cimber Camp video with this camera and the sound. Mostly I bought it because of the sound, because when it's windy you can hear the sound in the microphone, and I hope this little røde microphone, some of you know what that is, has a little hood on so that the wind noise will be not so so strong. So I hope you can hear it, and I hope you enjoy a little bit better sound. Mm. Mm. And particularly now when the camera and microphone is outside, it's a little bit wind here. I hope you can hear me more clearly than you used to do with my old camera. Yeah, and beside that wonderful Raymond flag I got from John, I got these things from another subscriber called Steven Nelson from the USA, and he made them himself, some Viking eating pickers. You see me use them in a lot of video where I'm eating my my steaks. It's very beautiful, and thank you very much, Steven. I appreciate that, and he also sent me this. Isn't this cool? A little pin. I think it's for sitting on Scottish clothes, I think. It's very cool. I can wear it on my clothes or put it on the back or something. I've not decided that yet, but I'm sure it will be used, and I appreciate that very much. So thank you very much, Stephen, for your kindness and support and generosity. I appreciate all your comments and your emails that you are sending me. So thank you very much, and Happy New Year to you. And then from another wonderful subscriber, Sean Watt, from Alberta, he sent me these bottles of whiskey. Well, it's a very nice gift. Thank you very much, Sean. You can see the Macallan whiskey is very expensive whiskey, and it has a wonderful taste. And then there's the Jack Daniels, a whiskey from Jack Daniels I never tasted before. It's with cinnamon. It's a really great Christmas whiskey. It tastes delicious, and I actually brought a flask with me today. Yeah, here it is. And I put some of that whiskey in there. I'm going to drink that with my coffee. So Jack Daniels whiskey with cinnamon taste. I don't know if you've ever tasted that, but it's very Christmas-like. So thank you very much, John, for your kindness, generosity and support. I appreciate that. So my wink today, Sean, is to you and your family. Very Merry Christmas. Yeah. Now, it's time for making my coffee. I got some other stuff I would like to show you. A company that sent me some stuff. But I'll do that after the coffee. Okay? Yeah. I wish you could smell this coffee out in the open air. It's so delicious. Yeah, let's have my coffee. Oh yeah. Let's see how it tastes with cinnamon whiskey. Skål, and this is for you, Sean, and your family. I think you told me that everyone is watching my videos, so I'm very grateful for that. It's actually very good, and well, I had an idea it would be good with cinnamon in coffee, whiskey cinnamon. Yeah, but not so strong, so I can put a little bit more in. Yeah. And then a good pipe of tobacco. This is life. Yeah, and then I would like to tell you a little bit about these things I got from a company in the States called Wasu, and they asked me if I would like to use these things in my videos. I'll start with this one. It's called a Viking whetstone, and those of you who have watched my Jule Nisse special saw that I was actually wearing this around my neck. And it's a little sharpening stone that they have made out of natural material from Arkansas. And it's a fine grit between 600 and 1800, 600 and 800 grit. And it has several places you can sharpen your things. And I say things, you will probably use this for your knife, but it's also have a little slot here that you can sharpen pointed things, example a fishing hook or something like that. I like it because it looks very old school, and they actually made this from a found here in Europe where they call it wet stone in the Viking Age. And look at this, the leather straps, it's so cool, it's very nice quality. And can you see this? This knot, yeah, it's so cool. I've tried to make it myself, and well, on the internet, on YouTube, you can find tutorials about this, and it's not that difficult. I think they are called Napoleon's knot. I'm not quite sure, but I think it's that. So this I'll wear when I'm out making my Viking videos, because it's authentic and looking very good. And then they sent me this, and this is something you can put around your neck too, and it's actually very cool because here you have a little ferro rod, and here a striker, a ceramic striker, and you can see lots of spark. So in an emergency situation you can use this, and you can use it for decoration around your neck. I think it's cool. And I'm very grateful they sent me these items. And They also sent me these bandanas. Yeah, I love these things. You can use it to wrap it around something. And actually, the print on this is useful too. You can see it is tracks from different animals. And I think they are saying that it's one-to-one. It'll say if you see a track that is this size, then you know this is a dog. And here you can see all kind of animals and their tracks you can find in the forest or in the nature, in snow or mud and even dirt. And on this one, it is about edible plants and non-edible. So this you can use not only to rub around things or have it on your head, you can also use it out in nature. If you meet one of these plants or footprints, you can find out which what it is and can I eat this. Or there's a couple of plants that they say you shouldn't eat and the ones that are safe to eat. So very cool. Go in and check them out. The zoo, of course, I put a link in my video description, and they have a lot of stuff. Much about survival, and that's not quite my style, but they have a lot of stuff like this, old school, and particularly this Viking whetstone. I love it very much. So thank you very much, Vasu, for your kindness and supporting me and my channel. I appreciate that very much. Yeah, and as you can see here, I'm almost have no wood left, firewood, so I have to harvest some. So I'm going to cut down a tree. I don't know if I'm going to cut it up in pieces, but first of all I would like to find a tree I can cut down. And these two I bring with me into the shelter so they can dry in there. Let's see, I think I found a tree down here that I can chop down. As you can see, a little bit of snow. As you can see, a little bit of snow on the ground, but not much. I don't want to cut down a big tree, so what option do I have? Yeah, I have to go in and look. Small here, this one and one behind there, and I'm going to cut them down today. And I'm using my new saw by Gather Canyon. It's a great one. This one is rotten, I think so. Yeah, it's no good. Then I have another one over there. Yeah, and this one will do. This is okay, and this one too, I think. Yeah. Inside here, I have one more.
Yeah. And it's stuck up there, I have to pull it out. Yeah. Three small trees for now.
Yeah, that was hard work. Yeah, it's uphill here, and well, I'm in a bad shape, I know that, but yeah, this is all for now. I just cut it up in long pieces, and I will put it in here my shelter, so it can be kept dry in here, and next time I will cut it in smaller pieces so it fit in my stove here. It's been a wonderful day, and I managed to do all my to-do list things, if you can say that, and I had a wonderful cozy time out here. When the stove is lit, I think there's about 15 degrees inside the shelter, even though it is open out to the forest, so it actually works very nicely, and I'm so pleased with it. Yeah, it's beginning to be dark now. It's 3:30, and the sun has gone down, and I'm heading home and edit this video and launch it perhaps Saturday. You know it when it comes. Yeah. Yeah. Again, thank you for watching Cimber Bushcraft. I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.